objectives of some wise radicals, the role of institutional and non-institutional sources of financing, farm investment, the problems faced by farmers in raising credit for farm investment. The methodology used were a sample of 150 farmers was taken from three agroclimatic zones of Punjab, district Bathinda, Ludhiana and Hoshiarpur were selected. Magnitude of own and borrowed funds in farm investment. The amount invested was 8.68 lakhs and in that own funds were 4.93 lakhs and borrowed funds were 3.75 lakhs. We can see that the share of own funds was increasing along as we increased the as farm size was increasing and the share of borrowed fund that was also increasing. In per hectare category, we can see that the share was 1 lakh for on funds and 83,000 for borrowed funds. In this, we can see that the share is maximum 1.2 lakh for semi-medium farmers. And it is declining both ways. For mutton farmers, it is also declining, and for large farmers, it is also declining. And for borrowed fund, it is decreasing as the farm size is increasing. Next slide. Share of own and borrowed funds in farm investment. Overall share of own funds was 56% and borrowed funds was 43%. We can see that share of own funds is increasing as the farm size is increasing from 32.83% to 69.60%. On the other hand, borrowed funds that are decreasing as the farm size is increasing. The share of borrowed fund is decreasing from 67% to 30%. The magnitude of institutional and non-institutional credit in borrowed funds. We can see that the share of institutional credit is 2.47 lakh and that of non-institutional credit is 1.27 lakh. In various farm size categories, it is increasing. Non-institutional credit is increasing, and institutional credit is increasing, and non-institutional credit is decreasing. Similarly, for per hectare basis, we can see that institutional credit is highest for semi-medium farmers, 71,000, and it is again declining both ways in marginal and large farmer. Both ways it is decreasing. For non-institutional credit, it is we can see that in all the as the farm size is increasing, the credit is decreasing. Next slide. Share of institutional and non-institutional credit in borrowed funds. Overall share of institutional credit was 65.98% and non-institutional credit was 34%. In the various farm size categories, as the farm size is increasing, the share of institutional credit is increasing from 28% to 90%. And for non-institutional credit, it is decreasing from 71% to 9%. Various problems, next please. Various problems faced in availing credit from institutional sources. We can see the list of various problems. It was mainly that a non-cooperative attitude of staff, offering security, rigid repayment plans, inadequate amount, poor consultancy services. All these were major issues which were given by farmers, which were asked to farmers, and they responded positively to all these. Problems faced in availing credit from non-institutional sources. In these, the major problem are high rate of interest, followed by offering security, and third was the inadequate amount they offer. Next is the reasons for availing credit from non-institutional sources. Major reasons were there was no requirement of paperwork, there was secrecy, easy access, timeliness, emergency requirements, and flexible repayment schedule available with non-institutional sources. The conclusions and policy implications. There was a significant share of credit in total investment made by the farmers. The investment credit per farm by farmers declined with increase in farm size in relative terms. In total amount borrowed, the share of institutional credit agencies increased with increase in fund size, and share of non-institutional credit decreases as fund size increased. Institutional sources were the main source of credit, and there is significant share of non-institutional credit in investment credit. Non-institutional credit agencies play an important role in farm business activity. Their working should be regularized so that government can keep check on their working.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
And all of the papers presented, they were of really worth. And the questions which came in one paper were answered in the second one. So all the papers were linked at the theme of the session. So you have made, you have given a very nice comparison why people go in for non-credit sources of loans or credit institutions. So you knew that sometimes it is the attitude of the person sitting over there, non-competitiveness, then whether they demand security or not, whether the program of repayment is soft or rigid, whether the schedule is of convenience to the loan seeker, and whether it is easy access, whether secrecy is maintained or not, or how much paperwork or the processing formalities are to be completed. So all these points, they affect the mentality of the farmers. Any objections? So I think in such a seminar, it is one of the important thing that you come out with a presentation. The slides are not to read each and everything. It is just to give you a hint what you are to speak. So normally what the youngers, they are now doing, they are just getting the text photocopied and making PPTs. So this thing is also to be learned. So I think these are the opportunities which make us meet the eminent personalities, and we can learn from them. So I congratulate each and every presenter, and I am very thankful to those who asked questions, and I am very thankful to the organizers for giving me this opportunity to chair this session. I personally learned a lot from this session.